Dear friends, welcome to the Anatomy Journal Club. As you are aware, this Anatomy Journal Club has been running for the last year or so in Facebook. I have a group of 500 plus members, and we discuss recent papers, recent literature related to anatomy and the relevant clinical applications. We have finished about 38 research papers discussion so far. Hopefully we will continue it for a little more time. But this particular video is something very different. Now, this is a nostalgic revisit of one of the previous anatomy journal clubs, which I'm going to recall and rediscuss it in the current present day scenario. Now, let me tell you this in a story form, because a very orthodox journal club will have a lot of, didactic and very, tables and statistics and things like that. So let's look at the anatomy journal club slightly in a relaxed way. Now, the year 1989, I was a first year PG student in anatomy. As a part of the curricular requirements, we had to conduct and participate and present papers in the department level journal club. I do not remember the finer details, but one particular day when the topic was allotted to me, when the journal club was allotted to me and I had to present, I had two papers. One was the real orthodox paper with lot of, abstract and introduction methods and all that real rigorous scientific stuff. But anticipating that this paper, however good it may be, I don't remember the paper, but it was something to do with skin anatomy. That much I am able to vaguely recall. I knew that, this will not last for 1 hour, because the 1 hour was the time slot. I knew I will finish it in half an hour. And as I predicted, I finished it in half an hour, and it was maybe another 5-10 minutes discussion was there, and that's it. Now, I didn't want to, feel bad in finishing it ahead of time, and so I had another paper which I had kept it as a backup paper, and I took this opportunity and presented this paper. The title of the paper was Two of Everything. You see, I repeat, Two of Everything. This is a paper from British Medical Journal. I have given the references. It's from one of the issues in 1989. That means at that point of time, it was a fairly recent paper. Now, this particular paper, I would like to recall and re-present in the current scenario. But I will not give you all the details of this paper that is there in the script, because having given the reference, I would like you to actually go through it on your own and derive your own interpretations. But I will give you a small summary, or I will give you a few snapshots of what it's all about. It's basically a very interesting debate where one of the authors, a clinician, raises an argument which is very relevant to anatomy. For example, he says certain systems, organs, structures are single and some are double. You see, therefore, the title moves to in the direction of single or double, an anatomical dilemma. The author goes on to argue there are two kidneys, two ureters, but there is only one urinary bladder. So it's not only a compare and contrast between systems, but also within the same system. Lung, two, but trachea, single. Testis, epididymis, ductus deferens, seminal vesicles are two, but the prostate and urethra. I mean, you see, you got the message. Extending the message, he draws one of the, he takes you into a discussion telling, oh God, with one system, namely the alimentary system, we have so much problems. What if the alimentary system was double? You see, that's the line of thought. That means this is a very good tail ender paper just to rethink of things in a gently humorous perspective. And that's what I'm going to do now. I hope you will appreciate and laugh at me in the spirit of a scientific discussion. Now you see, here is a disease about which we know rather very well. I repeat, it's an aganglionic megacolon. One of the presenting symptoms is chronic constipation. Now there comes the discussion. You see, when you look at the references for this particular topic, it says the colon can grow so large that it can extend up into the rib cage. Fine, and that's the reference that's been given. But then you see there are a lot of extreme cases reported in literature. Very recently, this is a very, very recent reference. There was a case of a 24-year-old man, reportedly, as quoted by the newspapers, a drug addict. He was refusing to eat in order to prevent himself from pooping out the evidence. That means the police saw him gulp certain material which is suspected to be some kind of drugs, and for 43 days he did not move his bowels. Isn't that a great record? Interesting, but worth investigating. Well, that's for the British police to look into it further details. But let us suffice that there are a lot of drug-induced constipation. Opioid constipation is generally known to us. Let's restrict ourselves only to the medical aspects. That was an interesting case. Next, let's look at it slightly from another perspective. Just like we have what is called walk the talk, let's weigh the talk. That means if we convert the current discussion into grams and kilograms, this is how it's going to look. That material, the output, I don't think I need to mention that, is approximately 400 grams per day, by per individual, 2.8 kgs per week, 145 kgs per year, and a whopping 11,000 kgs in a lifetime. Considering about 75 years to be a good enough lifespan for this comparison, right? And this is the reference for this particular data. It's called livescience.com. Reference is how much you poop in a lifetime. Next, let's go a little more beyond that and look at certain historical anecdotes connected with this organ of anatomical interest. We move to the country of Austria. There it is. And look at a very interesting narration. It's given in that particular reference I quoted at the beginning of the thing, and it is, I am just giving a graphic impression about it. Here is the country, Austria. There was a small town there. In this town, there was a person, a gentleman, who, as the author says, the fellow's bowels moved once a year, give or take a few weeks. You see, moved once a year, give or take a few weeks. That means around the time when he is getting ready, you see, when he is getting ready, the town will be informed that it's arriving shortly. You see, the whole town was alerted. That means it was an annual event of that town. Next, a public holiday was declared by the authorities to celebrate that day. I repeat, to celebrate that day. There was fun, there was dancing, there was festivity, all that. You see, public holiday followed by the message, here comes the poop, let the festivities begin. Here comes the poop, let the festivities begin. Then the local town band was asked to be in full function. Such was the annual day celebrations. To the best of my knowledge, I have not heard of a better annual day celebration than this, at least in recent times. This must have been a few centuries back. I could not get more data than what is mentioned in the literature. Let's proceed further. Although it is, you know, very, very, I would say, habituating to look at, you know, anecdotes like this in the world record, I couldn't really find anything. But then, similar to this one-year, you know, even annual event, there are references. Like I could find one, an abdominal X-ray of a 13-year-old with functional fecal retention syndrome, who could not recall pooping in the past 1 year. Well, we can't give much credibility to such documents unless otherwise they are documented in medical literature, or if it is in recent times, it must be an authentic news information. So we'll just leave it at that and keep moving. You see, 2017, there is a more authentic information, more reliable information of a person who was constipated for 22 years, habitual constipation in China. 13 kgs of the precious material was removed, and here is the piece of the large intestine. So surgical intervention had to be done. Now this reflects the seriousness of the disease, Hirschsprung's disease. Now that's what I want you to catch the point as far as clinical anatomy is concerned. Now it's time to conclude this short humorous anecdotal tail ender of a journal club, anatomy journal club. And I'm sure I'm all my well wishers and friends would love to have a small love story in this context. Here is a couple, a newly wed husband and wife. Maybe they were separated for some time, a little away from each other. And you know, these are the days of high connectivity. I would say internet is there, cell phone is there. So naturally, you could expect between the wife and the husband some kind of a I would say texting of this kind. Now you see, the wife did this following texting. Dear hubby, if you are sleeping, send me your dreams. If you are laughing, send me your smile. If you are eating, send me a bite. Wow, what a love. Let's see what else she says on WhatsApp. If you are drinking, send me a sip. If you are crying, send me your tears. I love you. Let's see what the husband replied for this. My dear wife, I'm in the toilet. Please advise. Thank you, my dear friends, for your patient listening and viewing of this video. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed presenting it to you.